Okay, so let's continue with the transistor in the mode of operation for MOS transistors. And first, we are going to look at the linear mode of the MOS transistor. So what it means by linear mode? So the mode of the transistor actually depends on the VDS. Okay, the VDS and VGS, gate to source, drain to source. So first of all, we know that if VGS is small, we've seen in the previous lecture, gate to source, okay, it's right here. So VGS less than VT, this is off, okay, no current flow. Regardless of what you give to your drain voltage, VGS less than VT is off. Now, in the case that VGS is greater than VT, so it's on, now we are going to apply voltages, okay, at the drain terminal. Okay, so here, that's minus VDS. Okay. I think it's like this. Okay, plus minus VDS. So then your current actually going to flow from your drain to the source in the case of NMOS. Okay, so we are going to apply VDS, and we are going to apply a small VDS, which is less than the gate source minus threshold. This is also known as VT. So sometimes you can say that VDS is less than VGT. Okay, so what happened to our current, and what is our mode of operation? Okay, so if first of all, it is on. Now we apply a very small VDS, and if the VDS is small, then if the VDS is small, then the mode of operation is called the linear mode, where your current is a linear function of VDS. Okay, so the as we ramp up our VDS, make it a little bit bigger, a little bit bigger. Okay, as long as it's a linear mode, our current will also increase linearly according to our drain to source voltage. Now let's look at the condition. What happens if you design your MOS transistor in long channel and in short channel? So first, let's say your L here 10 micrometer, okay, huge channel. Minimum we're using 250 nanometer, 0.25 micron. So the minimum L is 0.25 micron. But we can have a long channel device. For example, here we have a 10 micrometer length of the channel. Then how to calculate the current inside when we are in the linear mode? Okay, so it's given by this equation. Okay, so the transistor is on, our VDS is small, then your current is Kn prime WL, VGS minus VT times VDS minus VDS squared over 2. Okay, also this Kn prime WL can be simplified to Kn. Okay, here. Okay, so Kn prime WL is equal to Kn, where Kn prime is known as a process transconductance parameter, equals to mu n COx, where mu n is your electron mobility and COx is your oxide capacitance. Where your oxide capacitance, okay, your oxide capacitance equals to epsilon OX over TOX, okay. So epsilon OX is the permittivity of silicon, of the oxide, and TOX is the thickness, okay, the thickness of your oxide, okay, and that will give you your process transconductance parameter. Now, Kn prime WL is also known as a gain factor. If you multiply the transconductance with the ratio of width and length of your transistor, okay? So basically, the process transconductance is fixed. I mean, again, this is from the process engineers. They will give us this value from our model. And then WL is up to the designer. The circuit designer will determine. Okay, we determine what is going to be the width and the length of our transistor, and then we are going to apply VGS, gate to source voltage. We are going to apply drain to source voltage. threshold voltage is given. Okay, threshold voltage given. Kn prime is given. We apply some VGS, apply a small VDS, and this is your current. Okay, so for small VDS, there is a linear dependence between VDS and ID, hence it's called the linear region. Okay, let's look at the saturation region. Again, we assume that it's on, VGS greater than VT, and remember if it's less than VT, VGS very small, it's off. So it's on. Now what happened if we apply a slightly larger VDS, okay, where your VDS is greater than VGT? Okay, so remember previously we put a small VDS and now we go bigger. Okay, bigger means it's much bigger than maybe same value as a VGS. Okay, maybe same value as VGS. So what happened is when this is on, okay, so here is on, correct. Now when you apply a high VDS, you're gonna get something called a pinch off condition at your channel. And the pinch off condition will result in almost constant current. Okay, so ID is constant. Constant means that when you apply higher VDS, your current will remain relatively the same values. Okay, so then you have a different equation. Okay, remember previously, if your VDS drain to source is small, then it's linear dependency, VDS and ID, and now if VDS is big, you're going to saturate your current. Okay, so here is the equation. So for long channel, when VDS is greater than or equal to VGS minus VT, then it's KN prime W over L over 2 VGS minus VT squared. Okay, and notice here, no VDS. Okay, so you can say that at least in this equation, that if VDS is big enough, then your current does not depend on VDS. Okay, it doesn't depend on the drain voltage, since the voltage difference over the induced channel, which is a pinch off, remains fixed at VGS minus VT, is pinched off. However, the effective length of the conductive channel is modulated by the applied VDS. So in fact, it's not really saturated, meaning that the ID is not 100% constant. There is some change. The higher VDS you put, you're going to have a slightly higher current. And this is controlled by the 1 plus lambda VDS. Okay. So lambda here is called the channel length modulation parameter. Again, it's coming from the process engineer. What is our channel length modulation? Okay, basically it's saying that, and you can see the graph later, it's saying that the ID is not 100% constant at a certain ID value, but it's actually increasing a little bit as we applied more drain to source voltage. Okay. Okay, current determinants. For a fixed VDS and VGS in on condition, IDS is a function of the distance between the source and the drain, L, the channel width, W, threshold voltage, VT, oxide thickness, Dox, dielectric, epsilon, Ox, and the carrier mobility, I think it's called U, mu n. Okay, mu n. You can say here, this is your Kn prime or Kp prime. Okay, so remember your current is equals to Kn prime W over L, okay, function of VT. Okay, something like this. Okay, so your current actually depends on Kn prime, which is your Tox, Eox, Un. Also depends on your W and L. So the higher your W, the bigger your width, transistor width, the higher current you have. Okay, and L. So the smaller L, the higher current. Okay, smaller channels, higher current. So why do you need higher current? We can see later that if your current is high, then you can actually make your circuit go faster. Okay, so this is what you need to understand, that how to make your ID bigger, because bigger ID normally results in higher speed, okay, but maybe impact power as well. Okay, so so basically what we control as a designer is your W and L. Okay, what should you put on your L, what should you put on your W to get the optimum speed that we need. Okay. Okay, so let's look at the graph of the NMOS, the IV plot. Okay, this is looking at the ID versus the VDS. Okay, ID VDS. So what happened here is for long channel ideal. So here you can see the linear region. Okay, so here you can see here is a linear region. Here is a saturation region, and looking at your VDS. Okay, let's look at one example of this guy. Okay, VGS 1.5, and here they are simulating for channel length, drawn length of 10 micron, WL ratio of 1.5. Now, VGS is 1.5. Now, now we look at VDS. So we can see that VDS less than 1 volt. This is linear. Okay, for VGS 1.5 volts, so you say VGS is 1.5 volts. Okay, we fix the value. Is it on or off? It's on, because it's greater than threshold. Let's say threshold is 0.5, so 1.5 greater than 0.5, so the transistor is on. Now we apply VDS. Now if the VDS is less than 1 volt, then it's linear. If it's greater than 1 volt, then is saturation, and you can see that the current is actually constant. Okay, short channel effects. So in short channel effects, we are looking at what happened if our transistor length we draw as a minimum length, which is 0.25 micron. Okay, if you're designing 5 nanometer, your minimum length of the channel is 5 nanometer. Okay, so if we draw our length of the channel as 0.25 micron, then what is going to happen to our current equation? Is it still going to be the same? So it turns out that if it's a short channel, then you can see from here your electron mobility is going to saturate at a certain point of the applied electric field. Okay, so here is electric field, electric field. Volt per micrometer. So when we apply electric field, what happened to our electron mobility? Okay, so at a certain point, even if we increase our electric field, i.e. we increase our voltage, the speed of the electron will stay constant. Okay, and what happened if the electron stay constant? It means that our current stays constant. Okay, so that's what is called the velocity saturation. It's staying constant because of what is called the scattering effect, collision caused by the carrier. Because the channel is small, your electron is colliding. Okay, it's colliding against each other, which results in the constant velocity of the electrons. Okay, so for an NMOS device, only a couple of volt difference between the drain and the source are needed to reach the velocity saturation. Okay, so let's see the equation here. So for velocity saturation, in linear mode, okay, let's look at the linear mode. VDS is less than VDSAT, okay. So VDSAT is let's have a look later. Here's a VDSAT. So VDSAT is the threshold for between linear and threshold and saturation. So basically, the equation still remains the same, but then you have this kappa V, which is 1 equals to 1 over 1 plus V over zeta CL. It's a measure of degree of the velocity saturation. And the velocity saturation ID sat is also given by add another constant. Add another terms, kappa VD sat. Okay, so let's see what happened here. So what's the difference in long channel and short channel? So as we've seen before, here we set both the same. So VGS is VDD, Is it on? Is it off? It's on. Okay, because VGS is big enough. Now we are going to apply our VDS. Okay, so this is your ID. So we're going to apply our VDS. Now, if your channel is short, 0.25 micron, then you see here that your saturation is much earlier. Okay, whereas if it's a long channel, your saturation is here. Okay, and the current is also bigger, obviously. Okay, because you have a bigger channel. Now, for short channel device and large enough VGS minus VT, VD set is less than VGS minus VT, so the device enters velocity saturation before VDS reaches VGS minus VT, hence more likely to operate in velocity saturation. ID set, okay, ID set is here, so this is ID set, okay, the saturation current is linearly dependent on VGS, so reduced amount of current is delivered for a given gate voltage. Okay, let's look at the short channel IV plot. Okay, so ID VDS, drawn length 0.25, WL 1.5, and you can see here that okay so again, let's have a look at this. Okay, so remember previously your VDS less than 1, and now you have here is your VD set. Okay, VD set here is around maybe 0.7. Okay, let's see, 0.7. Okay, so if your VDS is greater than 0.7, then is in the mode is velocity saturation, not saturation anymore, it's called velocity saturation. Less than 0.7 is in the linear mode. Okay. Okay, so now we're looking at the ID and VGS. Okay, previously it's ID VDS, now ID VGS. Now for ID VGS, we can see that the dependence on the drain current on the dependent on of the drain current on the gate to source voltage. Okay, so basically for long channel, we can see that your ID will increase as you increase your gate to source, and for short channel it goes slightly below. Okay. PMOS, all polarities of voltage and current are reversed. So basically your current is a negative current. Negative current, remember, for PMOS, okay, you have a source connected to your VDD. So it's your drain. Okay. So your current flow is actually like this. Okay. Your current flow is from your source to your drain for PMOS. Okay, this is equivalent to a negative let's call this ISD. Okay, so it's a current from the source to drain, and your ID is actually your current from your drain to your source. Okay, so that's why in the end we say that the current flow through through a PMOS is actually negative, because it's going in a different direction than your IDS. Okay, it's on the other way around. Okay, so basically it's the same thing. I mean, so you apply a negative VDS, you get a negative current, and here is your small VGS, and the VGS, remember, has to be small enough, less than your VT, to be on. Okay, so let's look at the sub-threshold conductance. So what you mean by sub-threshold conductance is also known as the weak inversion conduction, transitioning from on to off in gradual decay exponentially, has equations in dynamic circuits and power consumption. Okay, so here we are looking at the ID VGS plot. Okay, and remember that your VGS must be greater than VT, that then only VGS greater than VT is the on state, right? So when VGS greater than VT, then we're gonna have a non-zero ID, non-zero current, provided that we apply some voltage to our drain data source, VDS. Okay, so actually, even VGS less than VT supposed to be off, okay, but not completely off. It's what you need to understand, not completely off. And you see here there's a current, okay. So if you think that you don't apply VGS, okay, you get to source zero, okay. But in fact, there is still some current going through from your drain to your source, okay, and that is called the leakage current. We're going to look at more later on. And finally, we have our unified MOS current model that we need to understand here. Our equation, this is the equation that we give in the exam, okay. So first of all, you need to understand that if your VGS is less than or equals to VT, then it's open circuit, means no current flow through your transistor. Now, if your VGS is greater than VT, okay, VGS greater than VT, then this is your current equation. K prime W over L, VGS minus VT, V min square over 2, 1 plus lambda VDS, and V min is actually depends on this one, which is the minimum of VGS minus VT, VDS and VD sat. Okay, so essentially later on we go through the examples. Basically, you need to calculate what is your VGS minus VT, okay, what is your VDS, what is your VD sat, and you're gonna take the minimum value from there. If your minimum is this, VGS minus VT is in the saturation mode. If your minimum is VDS, you are in linear mode, and if your minimum VD sat is in velocity saturation mode. Okay, so you want to check which one is the smallest. Okay, from your VGS minus VT, your VDS, your VD sat, which one is the smallest. From there, you can plug into the equation, plug in your minimum to the equation, and you can figure out what is actually the mode of operation of the transistor, if it's in off state, saturation, linear, or velocity saturation. So we have four modes. Okay, so this is off. Off, saturation, linear, velocity, saturation. And here also another equation that we can give if you need to calculate your threshold voltage. Current is determined by the voltages at the four terminals and a set of five device parameters. Okay, so these are the important parameters. VT0, okay, the condition to switch on your MOS transistor, and PMOS negative 0.43. Gamma, remember gamma here is your this one, this guy. The body effect coefficient, okay, this is the values. Typical value for this is a 0.25 micron CMOS, okay. VD sat, okay, 0.63, negative 1. Remember, VD, what is VD sat? VD sat is the VDS voltage such that the current is saturated in a short channel mode. And K prime here, okay, K prime is your processor transconductance, and this is the typical value. And then you have your lambda, which is your short channel modulation parameter, 0.06 minus 0.1. And here you use here. Okay. So we have everything. Okay. So we have the typical values. We're going to give this table to you. We're going to ask you, given these values, what is the mode of operation, calculate the current, maybe determine your VT, given certain VSB, Fermi, and gamma, and so on. So we'll go through some examples later on in the class. So I think we are done with this part of the lecture. So so the next topic is on MOS capacitance. Okay, MOS capacitance is the next topic. Going to go to the next lecture. But for now, I think we are finished. I'm gonna skip the next two slides. Okay, you can read this for yourself. It's not so important for now for our class, but it's good to understand more the equivalent resistance and transistor as a switch. Okay, so you can have a look at this yourself. I'm not going to go through. Okay, so I think that's all for this lecture, and for the next part, we're going to continue with the MOS capacitance.